Calculating toolboard needs for swing-out toolboards. Swing-out toolboards are very versatile in that they make the best use of shell compartments, for example, over a wheel well where a vertical slide-out may not be as practical, or, for example, they can be mounted with alternating pivot points at various depths inside a deeper compartment. For larger, wider spans, they can also be mounted as double French door swing-outs. And of course, they also have the full tool mounting pattern on both sides of the board to double your space utilization. A swing-out toolboard assembly comes with multiple sections of double dual track with end caps, handle, pivot, hinge assemblies, spring latches, and separate floor-mounted support and lock assemblies for fully open and fully closed door positions. For numerous installation reasons, the overhead PMF or pivot mounting frames are sized and sold separately. Before we get started, let us review some design constraints. The minimum required compartment depth is 14 inches. The maximum compartment width is 121¾ inches. Compartments up to 71¾ inches wide require one PMF frame kit sold separately. Compartments over 71¾ inches wide require one heavy-duty PMF HD frame kit sold separately. Compartment widths over 85¾ inches wide will be designed with double French door swingouts requiring a heavy-duty PMF HD kit and an additional PMF SP support post kit, also sold separately. To size and cost your swingout toolboard, we will need some dimensions from you. Height dimension. To calculate your swing-out tool panel height in a roll-up door configuration, let us start with an example compartment open door height of 40 inches. From that 40-inch open height, subtract a standard 2¾ inches for required gaps on the top and bottom of the swing-out door. 40 inches minus 2¾ inches is 37¼ inches. This 37¼ inches will be the total height available for the tool panel board, which will be built with rows of 5¾-inch uniform boards tightly assembled long edge against long edge. The 37¼-inch total height available in this example, divided by the standard board height of 5¾ inches, is 6 whole boards. This is the maximum use of the available space of 37¼ inches. Now that we know the height, we can work on the width. Toolboard costing is based on the cost of 10-inch long increments in finished toolboard width. In order to keep within balanced size and weight parameters, a short swing-out toolboard may be much wider than a tall swing-out. Recommended maximum lengths versus board height are as follows. A 2-to-3-board tall swing-out door can be as wide as 60 inches. 4 boards high can be 45 inches wide. 5 boards, 40 inches. 6 boards, 35 inches. 7 boards can be up to 30 inches wide, and 8 boards tall can be a swing-out door up to 25 inches wide. In the previous example, we were going to build the panel 6 boards high. Based on our chart, a swing-out toolboard 6 boards tall can be up to 35 inches wide. Armed with this information, measure your inside door opening width. Let us use an example of 36 inches wide. From any full compartment door opening width, we must subtract 5 inches for required gaps on the hinge and lock ends of the door. This brings us down to 31 inches wide. Referring back to our graph, 31 inches is well within the allowed 35 inches for a 6-board tool panel. From our example, these are the dimensions we need: 34½ inches high and 31 inches wide. The next step would be to secure the appropriate PMF frame for installation. When ordering your PMF frame, simply provide the inside width of your compartment as accurately as you can, as they are designed for a snug fit. That's it, height and width. If you need sizes outside of those recommended, please call a PAC representative for special design considerations. We would be glad to help. View our other videos online for additional tips and information.